So here we are with Android smartwatch platform, otherwise Android wearables as Google would like it to be known. Really, this is an extension of the main Android operating system, Android L, and really it allows developers to build their main primary Android app but include the smartwatch functionality. Now this is clever. When a user installs their app onto a smartphone, tablet, and if they also have their smartwatch paired up, a special smartwatch app will be pulled out of the APK and dropped onto the watch automatically. No separate applications, you don't have to go hunting for a smartwatch app for Netflix or something like that. Download the Netflix app. If there's a smartwatch component, it appears directly on your smartwatch. That is just so cool. They've shown a lot of this tight integration between the various bits of Android's platform here. And as I've already said in previous videos, this is really what Google I/O was about this year. It was about making all of Android's devices operate as almost like a single ecosystem. So if I wanted to on a smartwatch, I can dismiss notifications on my smartwatch and they'll be dismissed on every other device. Likewise, if I want to take control of my television set, I can do that from the smartwatch. I can put my smartphone down, move to the watch, and vice versa. This is all really cool stuff. You can imagine over time the power of having, well, a device on your wrist that can control any other Android device is a very powerful thing when we're dealing with Android TV, Android car, Android video gaming, etc. All of these options are there, and if you've got your smartwatch, who knows what developers are going to be able to do? Who's to say we can't have a virtual thumbstick on our wrist for controlling on-screen action? These are very cool times, my friends. Now, one of the things that disappointed me with smartwatch this time around is, unfortunately, we don't really seem to have very much in the way of cool-looking hardware. Essentially, the watch everybody really wanted and still wants is the Moto 360. The reason? Because it actually looks like a watch. It doesn't look like you've strapped an LCD to your hand. Now, the major problem really is that we've got two smartwatches coming through initially, an LG and a Samsung. The Samsung one, guess what? It just looks like a Gear. Wahey. The LG one just looks a bit like a Gear. So you're kind of just dealing with a, oh look, a candy bar strapped to my wrist. That Moto 360 looks like not only a beautiful smartwatch, but a lifestyle device. Something people are going to go, have you seen my smartwatch? People don't want something that looks like a color pebble. They really don't. They want something that looks like a smart watch. And a watch has a rounded, circular face. Simple as that. Now, one thing I noticed, and I don't know if anyone else picked up on this, but when they did the close-ups of the actual smartwatches, it looked very, very similar to the e-ink display technology that I think it was Qualcomm launched last year called Toc. And it's a very low-powered LCD in effect. And some of the things we were kind of seeing there, this always on, the smartwatch is always going to be on. You couldn't do that with IPS or LCD technology or AMOLED. You simply would kill the battery too quickly. However, what Qualcomm showed last year with their smart Toc technology certainly was a display that was designed to last for days but never be turned off. Interesting stuff. So I think what we may very well be seeing here is Qualcomm essentially is seeding the market with a technology that will allow these displays to stay on in black and white. When you touch the screen, it then pops into color. That's pretty much what we were seeing with Toc last year. So it looks like Qualcomm will not be coming to market with their own smartwatch. Instead, they'll be providing the technology to make this actually work properly to everybody else. That is exactly like Qualcomm. So how about you? Are you going to be picking up one of these new smartwatches? Will you be waiting for the Moto 360 to drop later this year? Do you think smartwatches and wearable tech in general are the next generation of Android? Do let me know in the comments and do please throw a like on this video.